Okay, now we're back, and it appears the Crystal Heart is broken, leaving the Crystal Empire to the harshness of the Frozen North, as Twilight pointed out earlier. Applejack then mentions how the Crystal Empire was able to be protected from the Frozen North when Sombra ruled, and even though Twilight says that the Crystal Heart wasn't missing, just hidden, that doesn't really answer the question, was the Crystal Heart protecting the Empire from the Frozen North, or Sombra? Anyway, Hayes and Twilight decide to go look in the library for a spell to fix the heart, while AJ, Rainbow, and Fluttershy go out to tell assistants to go to their homes without causing panic. Though, as we find out, it takes a panic to get them to move at all.
So we come back to see that Starlight and Sunburst aren't really moving on with their friendship situating.
Yeah.
Starlight eventually jokes and says, "Too bad there ain't a spell to put us, your friendship back together." Which Sunburst replies, "There is."
Yeah.
I'm just wondering, why would you need a spell like this? But then again, this isn't the first time we've seen a useless spell or completely unreasonably needed spell.
Yeah.
So Starlight and Spike leave. Starlight feeling that the worst thing that she could have done was coming to the Crystal Empire. Being that it's come up with her worst fear. And apparently, that is being rejected for a second time.
Yeah, because she thinks just because he isn't being open, it must mean he doesn't want to be her friend, I guess, is what she's thinking.
Apparently. So we return to find every pony still hasn't moved very far. And, wait, is that a stallion with two twin-tailed mustache? A donkey for a cutie mark? Okay. I'm not going to say what I'm thinking. No. We like to keep the... Yeah. Moving on!
Meanwhile, Kane and Twilight continue their search for a spell, and as always, Kane blames or remarks about Shiny Armor not watching the baby, even though he always does everything to the best of his ability to help out. Not helping Cadence then finds a large and ornately decorated book which holds the spell of Relic Reconstitution.
Wow. Shiny.
Yeah. Starlight then returns to the library, and Pinky recaps the half of the episode she missed. The baby then lets out a literally explosive sneeze that, after being reflected by almost every pony within the room, hits and practically ruins the book and the spells. Fortunately, Twilight was able to get a glance at the spell and thinks she can remember it. Cadence finally takes the baby after giving it and the responsibilities with it to Shining Armor all day. Of course, now he has to go and tell everyone still outside that they must evacuate and that the Crystal Heart shattered. This bit of news causes even the devoted fans to follow Shiny Armor, AJ, Rainbow, and Fluttershy out of the city.
We then return where Starlight and Spike return to Sunburst to see if he can help in any way to repair the Crystal Heart. And we find him, well, let's just say it looks like he's trying to reshelve his books. Does he do, like, the book sortation thing that Twilight does every year? Just randomly, when he doesn't want to do anything?
Yeah, right.
Well, it turns out he's not this great wizard that Starlight started to think he was. And he tells her that school was much harder for him than he realized it was going to ever be. And I can totally understand that. From somebody who was expected to excel a lot faster than they did in school. Starlight then recaps all of Season 5 for him. Pretty much.
Yeah.
And he apparently only hears the word time travel. And tuned everything else out from that point on.
Yeah.
Spike then reminds us that if we ever want to see Twilight or the light of day again, we probably should move on.
Yeah.
Before they're buried under 3 feet of snow. That sounds like where we're from.
Yep.
Anyways. Yes, on their way they see Tia and Luna doing something?
Yeah.
But apparently, it's moving clouds that have a will of their own is more stressful than Discord, Curic, or any other villain they've had in the last few years.
That's
evident by Tia's frustration.
Yeah, right. Starlight, on the road back to the castle with Sunburst and Spike, meet up with the mob fleeing the city and says that Sunburst can help stop the snow and restore the heart. So they return. Sunburst explains how one spell isn't enough to fix the crystal heart, and then after handing out spells to every pony else in the room, they all learn that he is not really a wizard. But Starlight is able to reassure them that they have nothing to lose and that Sunburst knows more about magic than any pony else. And so Sunburst is made crystaller, the crowd returns, and the crystalline process begins. Flying Cadence do their spell, Starlight hers, then the parents do theirs, and the baby rises above the crowd giggling. It's tickled. Sunburst then collects energy from the attending ponies and then makes a mad dash to the crystal heart, restoring it to power just in time.
How do we get crystallized? We're not even in the Empire. Does this wear off? Are we going to be stuck like this for the rest of our lives?
No, maybe not. That bad.
Maybe.
Oh, well.
Well, it's finally time for them to go home. And Starlight and Sunburst are sharing their last moment of the episode. Before everybody leaves for Ponyville. And everybody's thinking it, so I'm just going to say it. Sha-la-la-la-la-la, don't be scared. You've got the moon prepared. Go on and kiss the man.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't. Oh, well. Maybe we have the rest of the season for them to kiss.
So,
yeah, do something. Do something. Something.
Maybe just friends, but...
Yeah, friends. You've seen how well that word works in the show? We also see Twilight having doubts about the lesson and what she's done. She feels she has failed Starlight in many ways. Which Spike says, this is how Celestia taught you, Twilight. Spike, I don't think we need another Celestia. We got one.
One is enough.
Yeah. But I guess I'm not a princess, so I guess I shouldn't say that that's not the best way to teach somebody.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. That brings us to a happy ending, and the training is crystallization complete.
Yep. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and maybe I'll do more stuff with Tim in the future. I'll be doing episode 3 of season 6. Maybe Tim will join me for that if he feels like it. Maybe not. Who knows? I plan on doing more stuff in the future. So I'm Calliope.
And I'm Tim.
And we're signing out.